Darcy's dead. The dosage was too large.
You killed him.
No, I did not. I gave him life.
GP practice in Brighton was closed temporarily today after a member of staff tested positive for coronavirus. Four new cases of the illness in the UK were confirmed this morning, bringing the total to eight. The government has moved to ensure that anyone in England who's in quarantine for the virus can't just leave by declaring it a serious and imminent threat to public health, as our medical correspondent Fergus.
I thought it was a gun, you know. It just kind of cracked me up.
Was the baby dead?
Yes, it was dead.
The bullets had gone through her?
Yes.
Then what happened after that?
Well, after that, we had trouble with about five prisoners. And he told us the doctor. And then he comes, one of the guys in my squad, said, well, let's kill him. Lieutenant Kelly, what he said about this grave that they had, this big massive ditch. I think it was about 50 people at a time. They would put two machine guns on each side and put two people with rifles, automatic rifles. And he was standing over them, and he said, shoot them. So he just killed all of them, all 50 of them. And then they would make another pile of them, put them in a ditch, and then get another 50 and shoot them and do them the same way.
Broadcast by the Department of Defense of the Republic. At 2 a.m. Eastern Standard Time, multiple unidentified objects were confirmed to have entered Earth's atmosphere. It is speculated that these objects are of extraterrestrial origin. The broadcast will quiet at this time for your safety. Continue to carry out the following instructions.
We'll be right back. whispers about the financial support your government receives from the drug industry in Bolivia.
Well, the irony of this, of course, is that this money, which is in the billions, is coming from your country. You see, you are the major purchaser of our national product, which is, of course, cocaine.
On one hand, you're saying the United States government is spending millions of dollars to eliminate the flow of drugs onto our streets. At the same time, we are doing business with the very same government that is flooding our streets with cocaine.
Mm-hmm. See. Let me show you a few of the other characters that are involved in this tragic comedy. Here belongs to General Cucumbre. He is the Minister of the Defense of Bolivia, my country. And General Cucumbre, just a couple of months ago, bought a $12 million villa on Lake Lucerne in Switzerland. Now, if Cucumbre is supposed to be the Bolivian Defense Minister, what is he doing living in Switzerland? Guarding cash registers?